good morning and welcome to another edition of the Patriot Radio News Hour. We're rocking and firing on this 12th day of December 2019 in the year of our Lord. And this show is brought to you by the Patriot Trading Group. Legal, lawful, constitutional tender. A little gold and silver, that is. Grab some, hang on to it. Give some away at Christmas. Call 1-800-951-0592. You can also head out on the information superhighway, the World Wide Web, to allamericangold.com. Updated daily with prices, news, views. Let me tell you can just hang out there until the wee hours of the morning and do, you know, whatever it is you are doing in the middle of the night, unobstructed. Nobody will call you. You know, if you ever go on, have you noticed that when you go on a website for a car dealer, I mean, look, I think maybe I'm going to get a pickup truck, but they're just so expensive, I don't think I can pull the trigger. But you look at it, it's just like going to a car lot. You pull up the local dealer's website, and you're like, oh, there's one there, you're looking at it. And then all of a sudden, a salesman pops up. What are we doing here? You just turned me down. I like to broadcast right here. So anyway, Jason's in here. By the way, we're at the motherboard, the mothership. We are up in Colorado at KHNC, the Roar of the Rockies, and we're broadcasting through live on KXXT 1010. Not easy to get out. So this is an hour email delay back up to Colorado, which airs at 10 o'clock. So I'm joined with the owner of Patriot Trading Group, Joe Jaquin. Good morning. How are you doing?
Hey, good morning. Yeah, that's right. Right now in Colorado, Brian Kilmeade is on. We're running Brian Kilmeade every day, Monday through Friday. And while he's playing out on the airwaves, here in the Front Range, we're live down in the Valley of the Sun. I mean, technology, who figured?
Yeah, I know. I can't get used to it. I mean, we have so many things happening you can't even imagine. So I'm having the time of my life up here. I mean, it's amazing up here on the Front Range. People I haven't seen in 10, 20 years coming in. We always talk about it, and I talk about the original guy who called me here, the original broadcaster, one of them, Dr. Norm Resnick, who passed away. I met his son at the hotel last night, you know. And people remember, you know, we're looking at each other, and then, you know, it's funny.
You met him, but it wasn't like he called you up on the phone and said, hey, let's meet at the hotel.
No, he actually works at the hotel. I mean, what a small world. So I haven't seen him in 20 years, I think. So Dr. Norm, you know, he was amazed. He got this all started. He called me up, said, you want to do an interview? I'm like, yeah, who are you? Contacting this radio station changed my life. So here we are.
A quarter century later, broadcasting. It's amazing. So, but thanks to all our listeners down in Phoenix. We really appreciate it. You guys are amazing. Christmas time's coming. Wendy's down there. Arlene's down there. The office is very busy. They do a wonderful, wonderful job of keeping it going. They've been with us forever, with you, with me. Wendy, I stole her from our dentist 20 years ago. You know, I'm true story.
Wendy's worked there longer than I have.
Yeah, oh, yeah. She's been there forever. So
Arlene was a customer right before she started working for us. I mean, she's been a customer of Patriot since like 2006. I used to coach her kids in basketball.
Wow. So here we are. Here I am. You know, I'm enjoying this. I'm having the time of my life. Turns out, who knew? I'm pretty good at it up here. So a lot of fun meeting the people. The days just go by. Haven't eaten lunch. We had pizza Monday. I haven't had lunch at not once. You just work through lunch. You look up. It's gone. It's 5 o'clock. Where you know?
Well, you had lunch the day I wasn't here.
Yeah, the day you weren't
That's
here.
Right. That's right. No lunches.
Joe's cracking the whip around here. So you do a great job. You're doing a great job. We, you know, it's such an ominous responsibility to.
So much to do.
To do. I mean, it's
so
crazy.
Much to do.
But we're just, you know, we're just humble servants here. I mean, you look at what's happening in the country today. You think Debbie Lesko, our representative out of Arizona, I couldn't be prouder. Couldn't be prouder to be from Arizona. I mean, if you heard her this morning, she's, you know, you can watch it on C-SPAN. You can watch it on Fox. You can watch it on CNN. Other than that, all the local channels up here have the bubble-headed bleach blondes and the beautiful news women and the weather gals up here. Spectacular on TV. Right. And, you know, so those you go by, nothing. You look today, go to Drudge Report, look, nothing. They're trying to overthrow charge one of obstruction of Congress, I think it was, or which is the first charge?
They got two of them.
Yeah.
They're trying to get rid of
the first one. They're trying to strike it from the record. So
they got nothing. Because here's how I know they have nothing. Because if they really had something, all the mainstream outlets would be covering it.
They'd all be there. Right? So
they don't actually want you to hear what they're saying, because if you heard it, you'd be like, oh, come on.
It's crazy. So here you have it. Now, if they were impeaching O.J. Simpson.
Right. If we had a white Bronco.
Right. That would be everywhere. It'd be on every channel. There'd be no traffic on the interstates. Everybody'd be at home glued to the television. There's nothing. Nothing. It's crazy. But I will quote Representative Lesko. Says, if anyone is guilty of abusing power or obstructing Congress around here, it's the Democrats, not the president. This is the most corrupt, rigged railroad job I've seen in my entire life, she said. Close quote. That says it all. Now let's go to sports. For you people that are coming over from the sports, half the teams will be playing at home this weekend. Here's some scores. 25-7, 17-4, 8-3, 9-6. That was a close one. And half the teams this weekend, well, not all, 97% will lose and 3% will tie. And that's sports. We'll be back with weather after these messages. Yeah, we're still going here. Sorry, I guess my opening was a little distraught. They didn't get the mic levels right. So we'll just start again. Hey, good morning and welcome to another edition of the Patriot Radio News Hour, brought to you by the Patriot Trading Group. Joe Jaquin's sitting in here. I'm a Tuesday, Thursday child, but little by little, you know, Joe and I own the radio station up here in Colorado that I'm more and becoming more and more present. See, up and down.
I'm sucking him back in.
So I think I
thought he was out, but he's getting sucked back in.
I'm averaging about 4 hours of radio a day. So if you're on Phoenix, go to 1360khnc.com. Because let's face it, everybody's entitled to my opinion. And I saw the LSU game on. I'm watching it last night. And I, you know, they always show the bowl, like the aerial shot, the Goodyear blimp shot down at the stadium, you know. And one thing the SEC's always been good at, they put a lot of butts in the seats. So
a lot better than the NFL.
And then they realize that it's not the Goodyear blimp anymore. It's the Goodyear drone. Think about that.
It's a lot cheaper.
They don't need to fly that huge Zeppelin around anymore. And I mean, this is how things have changed. I think, how weird is that?
So. Apparently all the the Goodyear blimp drivers have to file for unemployment. Unemployment claims shot up like 50,000, which in today's world, that's a huge amount. It must have been the blimp drivers. I guess they all had to file unemployment because now you just need a drone.
You know, we like to desert camp in the winter. We get to get out there by quartzite, you know, Lori's family, and we go out there. And one night I'm just sitting out by the fire, and all of a sudden I hear this weird noise. You know, it runs along I-10 out there. It runs right in between L.A. and Phoenix. And I'm not kidding you. This thing, because it's just flat as a pancake, it wasn't 50 feet over the surface, and the blimp went right over the campfire. I mean, it was bizarre. Bizarre. No lights on, no nothing.
Maybe that's what all the weird sightings are. They're just blimps.
So, yeah, I don't know. So, crazy. So, anyway, the impeachment hearings are going on, and nobody cares. I mean, I asked the question yesterday on the forum, have they diluted society so much here in America? Has it been diluted to where, you know, how many illegals, how many people are from other places and dumbed down where, you know, they don't teach government, they don't teach any of this. They've just got people on with sound bites about, we want to give you everything and we need to change the climate. Has it just gotten to the point where they just can't attract enough attention and the majority of the public doesn't care if you impeach the president? Then they don't care. Go ahead. We don't care. Does it matter who's president? I mean, I wonder if this is what's going on in this country today.
Interesting. You know what? I hate to say it. I think you're right.
I think I'm right. They don't care.
They just don't care. I got too much stuff going on. I don't care.
I don't care. Do whatever. So this economy's great. Life is good. We don't worry about it. They think that all happens by accident. So we had Dave, the flag guy. He's amazing. Isn't he something?
Dave Cook is a special individual.
I said he was 72, but I think he's 74 years old. He looks like he's 50. He's here. He's got a flag booth. We set him up. He's been a broadcaster for 4 years. He's the best kept secret in the world. I mean, I know he did picnics and flags, but he doesn't really run it on the air. So now he's the official flag guy here at KHNC 1360. Yep. He just held up the Trump 2020 flag. I wonder how many he's got of those. We'll ask him during the break.
So. Yeah, if you want to order a flag, call us up here, 970-587-5003. We got U.S. flags, Trump flags. We got
Marine Corps, Army, Air Force.
Coast Guard, Navy. We got them.
We're a little short on just the regular stars. So Dave's working on that. So these are just a few of the things that are happening here. But this is not about radio station. This is about business news because I think, you know, people in Arizona are interested, but really what, you know, unless they're on vacation, which a lot of them will come up here in the summer, we'd love to see you up here at the studio. So it's not easy. I mean, you know, I've been saying now for a while, you're going to have to choose a side. You know, pick a side here. So, and, you know, the left has picked a side. They definitely
have picked a side for sure.
They are unanimous. And, but when the whole thing fails and blows up because they still can't get it through the Senate. They were hoping they were going to convert Republicans. They were hoping John McCain has still got, you know, maybe some followers there. And if they could get enough Republicans.
Hey, we just need a few of you to come over. If we get 10 or 12 of you, just because you just hate Trump so much,
right,
that we can get it done.
This is what they're planning on.
But now I'm here now, and I don't follow it like you. I don't. But I heard this morning. There's three, maybe now five Democrats that may be going the other way.
If that happens, they're done. I mean, their goose is cooked because it'll start infighting on that side.
Well, that's
what you want to do.
Yeah, that's right. How bad the case really
is. But that would actually make the right get stronger because if the left, because they've put up a solid solidarity front, but if they start bickering amongst each other, that's the first articles of The Art of War by Sun Tzu is to divide your enemy. So, I don't know. I want to thank Kent from Wyoming came in here yesterday.
Yeah, Kent, great, great guy.
Made a donation.
From Cheyenne. All of you out there in Wyoming, thank you guys for your support. And we boom out there in Wyoming.
And only going to boom more.
Yeah, so we're working on even more power and more range. All that stuff's coming.
This station goes Wyoming, Colorado, Nebraska. Let that sink in for a little bit. So we have a captive audience when it snows.
Well, I heard snow's coming again. A big snowstorm, I guess, supposed to be coming Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, and I'm going to be here. You're heading out Friday. I'm working all day Saturday. Someone's got to run this place. So, no, I'm just kidding. We're cutting all new spots.
We got a bunch of new spots. Got a bunch of advertisers coming in.
Yeah. So, well, it's just starting to grow. So, anyway, I don't even know where to go. You know, how about AT&T gives up Giuliani's phone records without a subpoena? Just gives them up. Just call. Yeah, what do you want?
What do you want? Oh, sure.
Yeah, we don't like that guy either. Well, Trump wants people to boycott AT&T. How about that? So, I don't know how you can do that. Is that like your power company? I mean, you can change your phone companies, obviously. So, I mean, it's just nuts. So, Fox's Gasparino says President Trump will potentially advocate for a boycott of AT&T, particularly its DirecTV brand. I think I have that.
I have DirecTV. Man, it's getting harder.
Wow. Charles Gasparino, Fox Network, reported today. Gasparino said his sources close to Trump indicate the possibility of being discussed inside the White House in the wake of AT&T's decision to hand over phone records of Trump's attorney, Rudy Giuliani, as part of the House Democratic impeachment probe. I'm picking this from the outside advisors to Trump, who says the president's inside advisors, even himself, they're really annoyed that AT&T turned over, without giving a heads up, all the phone records of Rudy Giuliani. I mean, it's just, you think that we're not lining up for a fight in this country? You think it's not coming? If you don't think it's coming, you got your head in the sand. Ultimately, it's going to have an effect on everybody. There has to be financial ramifications. There has to be. I mean, well, here's one. Stock market crashes, corrections. Who knows? Infighting throughout the streets. I mean, anything can happen. And I think it's going to happen over this. How far are you going to sit? Are you going to sit there and watch them? We're going to watch the House probably vote to impeach the president on these two stupid charges. You know, and let's face it. It's right down. You talk about just getting rid of your opponents when you want to run for an election.
That's all it really is.
That's all it is. Yeah. So it's sad. Yeah,
it, when you go back to the at least the ones in modern times, right? Nixon, Clinton, there was people on both sides that knew, hey, okay, yeah, we got a problem here, right?
When you're on present going, I did not have sex with this girl, and then they turn up a dress.
You got a problem.
You got a problem.
You got a problem.
You don't need anybody from Stanford to come on TV and go tell you why this is not right, okay? Nobody needed that one. Everybody got it. So, I mean, the fact that they had to bring these people on to tell you what the crime was. I mean, think about that. Are people that stupid? It really is idiocracy. See, when you rob a Circle K with a gun and shoot the clerk, you could go to jail, little Tommy. That's what we call a crime. I mean, is it getting down to that? Is the society so dumbed down? I don't know. So think about how crazy it is. The one guy that, Jonathan Turley, who came and he was one of the intellectuals. Jonathan Turley, professor at George Washington University. Remember?
You know, the ones that got rid of the colonial mascot.
Right.
Because GW. It was racist.
Right. They did. They got rid of their mascot. They had like George Washington with a three-corner hat in a Patriot, like a three-point stance or something, didn't they?
Yeah. I forget. They called it, their mascot was the Colonial.
The Colonial.
Yes.
And they got rid of it.
Yes.
Racist.
Yes.
Okay. So he testified as to why it was a crime. And then, of course, he says, you know, I received a lot of threats after that. According to CBS News, Nora O'Donnell said in an interview with Turley on Monday evening, says, my wife and my dog were threatened. Well, let's face it, the bitch had it coming, and the wife, too. Uh-oh, Ramon, better put that. Well, anyway, you know, it's dog. So
this is a paid program that is provided for informational purposes only.
Sorry, that kind of slipped out. So
that was Eric Cederstrom. By the way, his opinions are that of his own. Not necessarily
KHNC
and or Patriot Trading Group.
That's an industry term for a female dog. So I don't know. I don't see anything wrong with that. So anyway, all right. I apologize. You know what though? But that is pretty red. Insult the guy's dog.
Right. Come on.
You know, the wife, she's fair game. You know, she's a.
Leave the dogs and the kids out of it.
You could have said your wife's so ugly when she walks into rooms, mice jumps on chairs. But they didn't. They went after the dog. So I don't know. Yeah, that'd be fighting words. I actually, a good friend of mine, Skipper John, that I fished with on my 50th birthday, I went as a commercial fisherman. Remember I went?
Yeah, I remember.
I went up to Alaska and fished on a commercial salmon boat. Just a bucket list thing. I was a deckhand. I had to get a deckhand license.
He was a greenhorn.
Greenhorn. I had to do everything. I was 50 years old and was up there for a week yarding in fish. And the skipper and I became really good friends until I insulted his dog. He didn't talk to me for like 3 months. So depending on where you are, if you insult somebody's dog, man, that's fighting words. So anyway, you're listening to the Patriot Radio News Hour. You can reach Patriot Trading Group. Joe and Jason and Brian all own that. I do not own Patriot Trading Group. Joe bought it from me. I do own KHNC 1360 AM. Proud to be a part of this great institution. And it's kind of turning into a mental institution, but we're having a good time doing it. So, but you can reach Patriot 1-800-951-0592. You can also head out and order product on their website at allamericangold.com. So it's December 12th, 2019. It's a beautiful day here, a little cloudy in the Colorado Front Range. It's been sunny all week.
It's actually not too bad.
Hailing in Phoenix, sun is shining. This morning it was cloudy.
Yeah, well, the storm's getting ready to come. But overall, pretty good weather since we've been up here. We missed the big snowstorm the last time. I'm going to get out before this one. You may get stuck in it.
I may get stuck. Colorado Department of Transportation, real crack squad. A lot like the Arizona Department of Transportation. Interstate 25 is just like Interstate 17. Okay? It needs to be. You know, one thing, say what you want about California. California knew what they were doing. If you go back to when L.A. had a million people. You know, they had, they started putting these freeways in, and they were, you know, four, five, six lanes across each way. And they had a feeling, you know, hey, someone might move here.
Right.
You know? We might get some people here. Phoenix, oblivious. Obviously, Colorado. I mean, Interstate 25 is bumper to bumper 24/7.
They've got a lot of work to do.
A lot of work. So
Phoenix far superior to Colorado as far as freeways.
Well, the local, the freeways around town, but the freeways in and out, same problem.
Well, yeah, because you know, once you
I-17 disaster north of Anthem.
Once you get past Anthem and you want to go on vacation, then it's
You get up here around Fort Collins and Lupton and heading to Wyoming. I mean, it's this morning. I mean, my hotel is, I don't know, 6 miles, 7 miles away. A truck broke down on a two-lane road, you know, just packed. Took me a half hour to get in. So anyway, I'm not complaining. I'm bragging. It's a great day to be alive. Thanks for tuning in. It's halftime here on the Patriot Radio News Hour. We'll be back. Stay with us if you can take it.
This is the Phyllis Schlafly Report, a daily commentary continuing the conservative pro-family legacy of Phyllis Schlafly. And now, from the archives of Phyllis Schlafly Eagles, here is Phyllis Schlafly.
Lured by lots of federal money, at least 36 states and the District of Columbia have agreed to give up control of public education standards by their own state and instead substitute national standards written by the federal bureaucracy. Supporters of national standards claim that every country that beats American kids on international tests has implemented national standards. But at least one expert says, don't be misled. Neil McCluskey, education specialist for the Cato Institute, has a different take on this issue. When he joined me on my Saturday call-in radio talk program, McCluskey explained that while it is true that countries that score better than American kids on international tests all use national standards, the 12 countries at the bottom of those rankings also use national standards. Therefore, there is no correlation between having national standards and doing well on the tests. Most foreign countries have a national government and are totally unfamiliar with our system of federalism and states' rights. Dr. McCluskey said national standards will not help kids learn more for two major reasons. First, the unrealistic premise underlying national standards is that every kid should be learning exactly the same thing at exactly the same pace and time. Since kids have different needs, abilities, and interests, teachers need the flexibility to tailor education to unique students. The second problem is that even if standards start off high, it's nearly impossible to enforce accountability through government and the political system. The people who should be held accountable, the teachers and administrators, are the same people with the most political influence, which is exercised primarily through the wealthy teachers' unions. Attempts to maintain high standards and accountability have failed at district and state levels, and there's no reason to think the federal government can do any better.
This has been the Phyllis Schlafly Report with Ed Martin, president of Phyllis Schlafly Eagles. If you're busy taking notes, you can stop now, because these commentaries in written form and spoken audio are archived on the website, phyllisschlafly.com. Many recorded by Mrs. Schlafly herself. If you're doing research or missed a day, just go to phyllisschlafly.com. Thanks for listening and re-listening to the Phyllis Schlafly Report.
A hillbilly scholar, blue collar of a man. He came from the school where you didn't need nothing if you couldn't make it with your own two hands. He was backwards, backwards.
Broadcasting from the mothership in Colorado, we're live on KXXT 1010, Phoenix, Arizona, and also worldwide at 1360KHNC.com. You can tune in anytime and listen. You can monitor the broadcast and shenanigans going on up here now. You're starting to get a lot of attention. I expect the Denver Post to come through the front door at any minute. So
The doors are open.
Yeah, come on in.
Come on in. Love to have you.
The lights are on. I got to tell you, you know, it's a bane. It's a bane being 60. You get tired. I get tired in the afternoons. It's taking me a while to get rolling again. I mean, I'm running, working out. I'm at the hotel's got a nice gym and feeling good, keeping my energy level up. Obviously, you can hear it on the air. But at 60, you kind of about 5:30 or 6, I start to fade. Where at 50, when I was Joe age, I didn't. You know,
right?
Dude, nighttime radio, I just keep going. So get a little tired. Talk to my wife. Everyone goes, "You sound tired." Joe looks at me. "You okay?" You know, everybody's worried about me.
I did the other day. I went ahead and go check on him, make sure he's all right.
It's hard to unretire, you know, because the hardest thing is getting anywhere on time. Yes. Because I haven't been on a clock for so long. Like this morning, I got up 6:30, had some coffee, watched the Fox hearings, you know. I got to go at 7:30, you know, because I'm used to not having to go anywhere. I usually look at me and the dog, start looking at each other about 9:45. We going for a walk or anything today, Dad?
So, well, you know, what's so funny is when you first came back, started doing some shows, Wendy or Arlene, depending if it was Tuesday or Thursday, is Eric coming in? I'm like, I don't know. Maybe, I don't know.
I could barely get there. So.
I'm not sure.
It's weird to get back on a schedule again. So I'm enjoying it. I needed it. My wife, I told you, you know, she's, they hate to see you having a good time. That's why they close their eyes when you kiss them. So they don't want to see me laying around, you know, get to work.
Hey, in the last 3 days, you haven't called your wife one time to ask her, "Hey, what are you doing?
Yeah, what are you doing? What's for dinner?"
She's like, "Yes."
But now I have Lawrence at the hotel, makes me my omelet every morning. It's so bad. He looks at me this morning, he says, "The usual, Eric?" I said, "Yes, Lawrence." So it was like today. You remember the movie Trading Places, where at the beginning they
have Valentine.
Yeah, they got the orchestra playing, and they show the Dukes getting ready. That's how I felt this morning. I go downstairs, the Christmas orchestra music's playing. I've got my briefcase. Yes, pork bellies. That's what it is. I feel guilty. So. But anyway, part of the bane of doing nothing is this Netflix miracle. I mean, you know, God knows what this has done to society, the binge watching. And everybody just don't look at me like you're looking at me. You are all doing it too, you people. You know what I'm talking about. You get drawn into these series, you know. So the marvelous Mrs. Maisel she's a Jewish gal, a comedian in the 50s and 60s. And great series. I really enjoy it because she's a comedian. She's funny. It's interesting. But it's circa 1959, 62 is what they're up to now. And a woman as a stand-up comedian, you know, it's cutting edge. But she's in New York this season 3, and she's cutting spots on radio hours. She's a voiceover.
Voiceover, yeah.
Kara came in voiceover, and who knew she's as talented as she is. So she's going to run an entire department here. And probably end up with her own show. But the marvelous Mrs. Maisel, this is how they tie this in. You got to pay attention. So she goes to do live reads, not cut spots, but live reads at a show for some speaker. Turns out, now, the people in Phoenix, we play the Phyllis Schlafly Hour. Phyllis has been passed away now, I don't know how long. And whoever does the voice, she was, you could tell Phyllis was a smoker. Right. Hi, how you doing? You know, she was tough. Woman,
tough.
First anti-New World Order, anti-abortion, you know, hard-hitting. And she was around a long time. She was around so long that Mrs. Maisel shows up to do a spot for a live show. It was Phyllis Schlafly. Guess what? Refused to do it. Ran out. Because she's not good. This is how they tie in. These are the liberal thoughts that come in. They pull Phyllis Schlafly out of anybody. And she refuses to do the spots because Phyllis Schlafly's a racist.
No kidding.
How about that? So I hate to be a spoiler for you people that haven't seen it and maybe you don't watch it, but the Netflix thing, I got to break that. I'm going to shut it all off. You know, there's a lot of other things I could be doing, like, oh, I don't know. How about radio?
I don't know.
I don't know. Something like that.
Getting advertisers. I mean, all kinds of things.
It's crazy. Crazy. It's crazy. You know what? I'm glad. This is what I'm so proud to be here. I'm having the time of my life. I told Lori we're going to have to get a house here, so I'm going to need Dave Morgan. There's just no way around it. There's just no way around it. Joe and James I realize Morgan, yeah. So James Morgan, sorry. So our realtor, he's our official realtor here. If you live in Colorado and you want to get out of the snow and the cold, Lori says it's going to be 68 degrees and sunny at the house today. Go to thecederstromgroup.com or just Google Lori Cederstrom. She's my wife of 32 years. She is a real estate dynamo. And
see, so now we got Arizona and Colorado covered.
Right, we got it covered.
Whatever way you want to go, we got you covered here.
And what's amazing is how many people come from, you know, we've been kind of running spots here for about 3 or 4 years. I'm going to actually cut an official one at the station this weekend. But, yeah, there's a lot of activity between the two states, mostly people that looking for a winter place, you know, to get out of the snow. So, but you know what, here, the snow, the sun shines. People don't really understand. I didn't either. The sun shines like 320 days a year on the Front Range. So
yeah, it's not like Syracuse, New York.
No, you don't get the nuclear winter
where it's all gray all the time and all that. The
or
sun
Seattle
comes up.
Or something. Right. So anyway, here's what I mean about being part of this. Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders. Now he's becoming more and more irrelevant because he's just, I think, just getting too old. But he's a very well-spoken orator. And he can fire up a crowd.
Oh, he's got passion.
He's got good passion. And his crowds are big. He would have beat Donald Trump. I called it. He should have been the Democratic nominee, and he would have beat Donald Trump. That was my call. And they took it from him. Trump beat. The rest is history. They messed up. They know it. They're trying to undo it. So, but Sanders says he's endorsed an entire ban on oil and gas drilling in the Northeast, Nevada, Ruby Mountains. Now, you don't understand what's happening with fracking, especially up here in the Front Range. Those frickin' frackers.
Frick and frack.
They're everywhere. Both of them. We had a guy come in. You know what's funny? I'm attracting 60-year-old men. So, and you guys know who I'm talking about. We've had a half a dozen come in and go, I'm your age. You know, we're the 59 models. We're the last of the Mohicans born in the 50s. So we all turned 60 this year. We had the oil field guy come in. Yeah, yep. Your age. Kent came in yesterday.
I'm going to tell you, we've got a lot of oil field workers. All you guys out there in the fields, we appreciate you guys tuning us in and doing business with us. Can't thank you guys enough.
Yeah, it's crazy. So, I mean, and they're still here. So we must be doing something right, you know. I got to tell you that. You know, I left home at 15. I grew up pretty hard, and you know, like everybody, like Jason too. I was a wild kid. You know, I had it all coming. I deserved everything I got, but was somehow able to right the ship. And when I got my first credit card machine at Patriot, I'm like, I can do what? I can just run people's credit cards? Those fools! And it was an ominous responsibility, you know? I mean, this was really something 20-something years ago. Now, I have a radio station. Those fools! How did this happen? Anyway. Patriot Radio News Hour, taking a break here. Whoo, and we need it rocking and firing. Stay with us. We'll see you. Support our advertisers. We'll be back. Oh, yeah, it's 9:44 in the Valley of the Sun. I hope this finds you well. We're all the way up here on the same time this time of year up here in the Front Range. We're live in Phoenix. We'll be email delay coming in Colorado. Come on up to the radio station. We'll be here. If you want to come up and see us, we'll be working here all day. Maybe we'll have a special, you know, anyone who brings us lunch. So the world keeps spinning and spinning. Joe has been working on something for how long now?
Well, I can't take credit for it. Jason has been working on, we are doing, this is a Christmas special. So if you're looking for that one Christmas over the top gift for your significant other, this is going to be it. This is the day for you guys. It's been over a year in the making. We've been slowly collecting rolls of Silver Eagles from different years. This morning, we finally completed our first set. So we have every year of mintage of Silver Eagles. We have the books are coming. We're gonna what we're gonna have is we got this book. You guys have maybe seen them out there. It starts with 1986 and it has every year. We've got every year all the way through 2019, all of our Silver Eagles in these books. They're not worn and toned and beat up. You'll see a lot of those types on eBays. These coins are all sharp, sharp looking coins, fresh coins. Every single year, all in a book. So you get a coin from every year. The 86, really hard to get. The 96, really hard to get. Believe it or not, 92, 93, 94, 95, 97. They're all carrying premiums. They're all hard to get. We've got them all for you. You can get every single year of Silver Eagle mintage.
In a book.
In a book. Really.
Up to what year?
All the way to, through 2019.
2019,
yeah,
okay.
All the way through 2019.
So you got 86.
86, 87, 88.
Do we really have to count? Some people went to public school.
Well, you know, it's a lot of years.
How many coins? Yeah, I don't even know.
It's a lot.
Yeah. You don't know how many. No, you got to count the first and the last.
35, I don't know, something like that. We only have 20 books.
You know why? Because you can't. You can only get limited rolls of the 86, 96,
86,
92s. They got big premiums on them.
I mean,
yeah.
So we are. We're trying to do it again for next year. We still need 10 or 11 more rolls for next year's version. But for this year, we've got 20 books. Spectacular Christmas present. It looked great in somebody's office or, you know, wherever on the coffee table, just something neat for, everybody to look at. There are 34 total dates. Thank you, Jason. 34 total dates, $974 for the book. We have 20 books. Arlene is available to take your orders at 800-951-0592. That's the toll-free number. Call and get your Silver Eagle book, $975. We will have them for you before Christmas. So all of the stuff will be here in at the Front Range early next week, and then be down in Phoenix late next week.
Yeah, but you got to call an order.
Got to call an order ahead of time because right. I would be shocked if they last through the Colorado Front Range show.
Great
Guess Christmas
what? Gifts. I want one.
There you go. We got 19, just like that.
Sell one. I'll take one. So put me down. So KHNC will buy a book.
I just bought half a book.
No, I'll take it. I'd like to have it. So
be great. You know,
hard to get some of those years. And that's the book's not a huge book either.
It's not a huge book.
It's not like an atlas or
Listen,
something.
Could
it's
you, if you had a roll of each one of these things, it'd weigh like 65 pounds, you know, by now with 34 rolls of Silver Eagles in it. This is one year, every year, one coin per year. So the whole book's going to weigh maybe 3 pounds, something like that. And it comes. It's a great looking book. Just a really something neat. We wanted to do something unique and special for Christmas that we've never done before. When Jason first told me about this, I was like, okay, you know, sure, Jason, do whatever. And
hard to do. You think it's easy?
No,
hard to do. I know.
I actually thought he would just give up. And then about 4 months ago, he called me and said, I'm down to just 6 years. I need 6 years. I'm like, what are they? And I actually had like three of the years that he needed in my vault. And then we got close. And then we finally, yesterday, we finally completed it.
You want to know what's so funny? You know why the 92s, the 3s, 4s, 5s, 6s have such huge premiums on them? Try to buy a 96 Silver Eagle or not any of those. Because silver was down to $3 and $4.
Yes.
And nobody wanted it.
No, they meant 4 or 5 million.
Yeah, they didn't make any. They only make what they can sell. It's just like Buick, okay? If it says limited, it's limited to how many people will buy. That's just what it means. So if you put it in order, and this look at the numbers they make now. So the mint takes all these pre-orders of millions and millions and millions. There's so many people that are holding these, it's just crazy.
Yeah, a bad year today is like 20 million.
Yeah, what's 96? 3.5?
3.5 million for 96s. And the 96s, and a lot of you, if you're a real collector out there, you know this. They did a poor job in 1996 when they're minting these coins. They run them through, you know, they clean them and they run them through this solution. and somebody at the Mint fell asleep and didn't change out the filters soon enough. So a lot of the 96s, they got these milky spots all over them. You're not getting those.
You know what?
Boats.
Nobody knew why. I didn't know why.
Well,
until this morning,
I dug into it. Yeah, I dug into it to find, because I wanted to know why is that. So
when I retired, nobody knew. They just like, yeah, if you had splotchy, they call it. Splotchy 96s, they didn't bring as much money.
Didn't clean the filters or change out
that
the solution.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah.
Wow. They thought it was, back then, they thought it was the plastic compounds in the roll that were splotching them. But it turns out was filters to wash the silver. So, okay. Well, we're going to take a break here. We'll be back. Stay with us. Thanks for tuning in. We appreciate it. Hey, Merry Christmas to everybody on this 12th day of December. Boy, closing in on Christmas fast. The time really goes by. I want to give a shout out to Aurora Eddie. Been a great Patriot, good follower. He wanted to come up and visit us. I got an email from him. He said he had transmission problems. So, don't worry, we're going to get a transmission sponsor now, here. So
we'll work
give
on
everybody
that.
A break.
Now, let's see. Is Aurora Eddy the UN flag?
No. I don't know if that gentleman's still with us. He used to come to all the picnics.
Yes.
And you could wipe your feet on the UN flag.
I did. I wiped my feet the one picnic I was at.
Yeah. So anyway, Jason came in and told us more about the Silver Eagle books. Okay. Now, there's two slots left on the page.
Correct. So this book that you're going to get, we'll also have room for the 2020 coin and then the 2021 coin.
They're not included, obviously.
Right.
You'll have to buy those as they come out. Now, the book has all the mintages of the mintage amounts to date.
Yep.
And facts on the Silver Eagles are in the book. And then here's what's even cooler. So now I want one for my granddaughters, but you can unbolt the book and next year as this goes by and add a page for 2022, 2023, 2024, 2025. So as it goes, see, Joe's smart. He's building in customers. You know what you should? If you had 10,000 of these books out there, you may not have to do a radio show.
Well, I can't find enough coins.
Hey, what year is it? Time to get Silver Eagles. Anyway, so they're beautiful. Legal waffle tenders.
Yeah, 800-951-0592, the Silver Eagle book. Right in time for Christmas, just a great Christmas gift. The book is really neat. Like Eric said, you're going to get the history of the Silver Eagle in there. All the mintages of the coins that are in the book will be in there. So just neat gift and something I'm telling you right now, it took us over a year.
Yeah, they're hard to do. We never did them all the years. We did certified ones you had, but that was 15 years ago. I mean, yeah. It'd be so heavy to ship a certified box of Silver Eagles. It would be a huge box. So anyway, call 1-800-951-0592. Silver's still way, way undervalued. Who knows what's going to happen? Who knows? Who knows how far this impeachment thing's going to go? I mean, just based on that, look at what the national debt, the clocks are running into oblivion. I mean, eventually we're all going to have to pay the piper. And you know, they try to inflate out of it. You know, obviously, if a gallon of gas is $82, the $50 trillion debt doesn't look so bad. And, you know, that's just how they try to justify this debacle. But ultimately, we will default on the debt, and they will change the currency. It just has happened in every society. No society ever has paid off their debt. They just wipe the slate on the old money and bring in the new. But remember, what they have costs a lot more than what you got. That's just how they do it.
Isn't that the truth? 800-951-0592, Patriot Radio News Hour, Patriot Trading Group. Want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas and pick up those sets. They're $975. Arlene just texted me, 16 sets to go. So we just sold three of them just in the last little bit there. So they're $975 for the Silver Eagle book, and you'll have it before Christmas.
Some of them you can pick up in Colorado. Some you can pick up in Phoenix, right?
Correct.
And you'll ship some, too.
Yes, if we have to, we will. Yep.
What more can you do? Go out and mow their yard. How about that?
No.
You know what I like about Colorado, because it reminds me I lived in Washington? Arizona, you got to do yard work year-round. Colorado, once the snow falls, whatever was laying there, you're not going to see it again until spring. You got to love it. So, Silver Eagle Brook, call 1-800-951-0592. Thanks, everybody, tuning in. I'll be on more later today in KHNC. God bless everybody. Have a great day. Bye now.